Ballerina who presents with these exact symptoms, and ever since she got to the clinic, here's what we've been working on. To create an immediate relief in symptoms, I mainly work on two major hip flexors, the first one being the psoas major. The top end of this muscle lies right under another back muscle called your quadratus lumborum. And when I get around that quadratus lumborum, I can get right into...
So people still think they can directly affect the psoas major or the quadratus lumborum specifically, right? Because this guy is claiming he can go around the quadratus lumborum and go to the psoas major to massage it directly and have a direct impact on that muscle. That is such outdated advice.
Very useful to work on a muscle called the iliacus, which is another major hip flexor muscle. This muscle lies right on the inside.
Or directly working on the iliacus muscle. Like these notions are super outdated.
Side of the pelvis. So if I get my fingers up and around that edge of the pelvis, I can get right into that muscle. These standing marches with a heavy weight on the bottom of the foot where she tries to control the hip flexor up into that range of motion, both with her knee directly out in front of her and with her knee out to the side, along with this variation where she goes through a full range of motion in that hip flexor.
So I don't think there's anything wrong with therapists still touching their clients, giving like a massage technique or whatever, but stop justifying it and let's be honest about why it can have effects on the client and why it can be useful and how it can actually help reduce pain for clients. Because only focusing on the biomedical side of things, where you really put emphasis on the structures like the psoas major or the iliacum, is way too mechanically based. It leaves no room for the psychosocial aspect of things. And it's just outdated. I don't mind touch for the fact that it can improve the therapeutic relation. It can be something the client really wants and has good experiences with. For the neurodynamic stimulus that it gives, the non-threatening stimulus, non-threatening inputs, as well as the general effect of therapeutic touch. But arguing everything from the biomedical side of things, where it's the, oh, I'm really targeting the psoas major, really targeting the iliacum muscle, that's just silly. It's outdated. It's not going to have drastic effects on the muscle, and people are not going to understand where their pain is coming from. Pain is a subjective, context-dependent experience produced by the brain in response to an actual or perceived threat. It leaves room for three components: biological components, psychological components, and social components. Only focusing on the biological components is missing the point of how to treat pain. Stop pretending like we can directly affect the muscles and like directly affecting the muscles will help your pain experience. The exercise is good. I have a problem with the way he represents it and is explaining it, because like I said, it doesn't leave room for a psychosocial or biopsychosocial explanation of things, and I feel like it can put dysfunctional illness beliefs in people's minds.